Let's go back to the original point. We were talking about Dave and Dave's assessment of the AEW deal. I know it's a little bit out of date now because some people have heard this, but for those of you that have.
On the West Coast, it will air live, so it won't be a three-hour delay like television.
AEW content that airs on EWBD Network will also be available to stream on Max On Demand. And starting later in 2025... AEW and WBD will offer live pay-per-views on Max at a discounted price per event.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but you have to subscribe. But you still have to subscribe to Max every month.
So you have to subscribe to Max, you get the pay-per-views on a discount.
Yes, but it's essentially the UFC deal. So this was.
It's not the UFC deal. It's nowhere near the UFC deal. I don't know where. Well, because he's just spinning plates at this point. But as we kind of addressed it on last week on Thursday, you get a discount, but it's still available at like pay-per-view.com. It'll still be available on Triller, Fight TV, whatever you want to call it. It'll still be available for full price outside of the source. And one of the questions that he dodged on Conan, he dodged it again. And some other interview, Tony Khan being the fact that Warner Brothers now has a percentage ownership but here let me play a little bit more. Sorry.
A lot of people are asking about this one. So the basic gist of this is that, you know, WBD is not looking at losing more money, and the WWE deal, while it's great for the fans, it's a big money loser because, you know, Peacock is spending like $200 million a year for something that is not the value of $200 million a year. Although,
Based on what?
Wait. So WWE is not worth, their pay-per-views, including WrestleMania, are not worth $200 million, but how much is the AEW pay-per-views?
No, that's not, he's not saying that WWE isn't making money. He's saying that by Peacock having WWE under Peacock, Peacock is now losing a shit ton of money. Like, they're the ones that are getting fucked in this deal. And it's like, I don't understand. How? Based on what?
Upon nothing. I mean, really, if you look at it, the Peacock app's not doing good, but also most of these fucking streaming apps seemingly aren't. And on top of that, if you go onto the Peacock app, WWE is like a big chunk of it.
Right.
They dedicate a big chunk to it. So if this was really not doing anything for them, or they weren't even attempting to recoup their losses, and they were like, oh, we better cut bait on this thing.
Okay.
Why would they put it front and center so often?
CJ in the chat is trying to use logic with this because the subscriptions don't match the amount of revenue that they're spending.
Okay. But how do we know? Okay. How do we know for sure? In that situation, who's subscribing specifically for Peacock and who's specifically subscribing for WWE? Because I'd be willing to bet there's a lot of people. And when Peacock was free through the Comcast platform for a long time.
That's what I'm saying. It's like when that was free, when that was part of the Xfinity deal, I mean, those WWE numbers were through their fucking roof.
Of course.
So I don't know. Like, I would imagine they're using the same type of metric measurements then that they're using today, right? So if they were measuring how many people were turning on WWE with Xfinity packages versus the paid people, I'm sure they saw that too. And now that they don't have the free Xfinity packages, I'm sure they can watch the WWE deal or see people that tune into WWE or watch the specials or whatever else like that and make those measurements. How Dave found out this information and knows that Peacock is losing money based upon those subscription numbers, I don't know.
Oh, well, I mean, his number one source is Trust Me, Bro. That's his number one source.
Right.
Because that's it. It's like, and by the way, I'm not sitting here saying I know. I'm not like, oh, yeah, let me guess what's going on here.
No, oh, believe me. And let me clarify, too, real quick. Ninos, dude, we are not pro Peacock whatsoever. Peacock's UI, like a lot of the issues with Peacock are just abominable. I wish we could get the WWE network back as a whole. I really fucking do.
Yeah. And anybody that's in this chat right now, in this Discord chat, one of our like little bumpers, like one of our silly things that comes up is it says, you know, you helped Joey skip through 25 Snickers ads because what was it? One or two WrestleManias ago?
Yeah.
Or something, some big show where I had Peacock and I'm sitting there and I kept getting the same fucking ad.
Right.
For literally almost a half an hour. And yeah. I was like, is this fucking serious? Why am I watching it? And it's like, do you know what peanut butter and nougat is? Have you heard of nougat? And I'm like, what the fuck is going on? I'm like, did a bomb go off in the arena? Are they going to play something? And like, I had no idea. I thought maybe the building was on fire.
It was a Wyatt Six attack. I wasn't sure.
Yeah. Right. I'm like, what is going on?
Right.
So trust me, I don't think either of us are like, ooh, that we're like big fans of the Peacock streaming. No, what the fuck? We don't care.
Dude, Peacock itself is a problem. It doesn't matter if you watch WWE, if you watch any of the other shows on there. So you know, like they have Law and Order and Parks and Recreation. I don't think Peacock is a good streaming service, period. Like, regardless of WWE, I just think that Peacock in itself has problems. Casuals just throws up that Peacock quarterly loss narrows to 348 million as subscribers drop to 33 million. Is that WWE's fault? Is that where Dave is going with this? Completely WWE's fault. I mean, just look at the numbers.
It has nothing to do with the squeeze that people are feeling on all of this shit. And the amount of people who I'm sure at this point that are over the age of whatever, 40 or even above that, that get all of these apps and then eventually go, this is cable. Why don't I just have cable again?
It is.
Because if you went and anybody that's listening to this, go talk to your older aunts, uncles, grandma, grandpa, whoever's still fucking kicking around and say to them, hey, are you still fucking with cable or are you sitting there playing with an Amazon Fire Stick? I'm betting that most of them, unless they're like barely a television watcher and doesn't care that much, they're just like, yeah, I just got basic cable at this point because I'm sick of dealing with all this shit.
Yeah, it goes on to pretty much say that they were losing $651 million, and now they're only losing $348 million, which is good. It's good for Peacock. But at the end of the day, I don't blame WWE for Peacock's mismanagement. In the same way that I don't blame Warner Brothers for losing all their money. It's not AEW's fault.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're going to go tit for tat, then wouldn't you kind of blame AEW for any kind of Warner Brothers loss at this point?
Like, yeah, let's ignore the fact that they just took a fucking bath on that shitty Joker movie they made. That's AEW's fault.
Right. Of course.
Yeah. They lost 80 or 90 or $100 million on that because AEW sucks. Right.
Though it's the value. It is the value to them because they're paying it. But, you know, they're not recouping it in that way. And again, and WWE may even get more when this deal's up in 2026 because streamers are looking for WWE content.
Yeah, because it's the case of Max, of course, Dave. Yes, that's why.
They're not looking at losing money by buying AEW pay-per-view content and then giving it away essentially for the price of a subscription. So, I mean, the deal. I mean, I'm sure AEW, without a doubt, would love to have the WWE deal. Anybody would have all that money guaranteed, way more than the market value, or way more than they were making on the pay-per-views themselves. Of course they would do it. But, you know, I mean, WBD wasn't looking at doing it. So if...
So WBD, Warner Brothers, was just kind of forced into this deal. That's what he's making it seem, at least for as far as the pay-per-views go, the pay-per-view content. Yeah.
Oh, well, I mean, to some extent, this is what happens when, and I called this 6 months to a year ago when all this conversation started happening. This is rich people washing each other's hands.
Right.
That's what, I mean, why do people not realize that this is a fucking thing? Oh, hey, can you get my kid a job? All right, I guess so, man. You've been my fucking friend for a long time. I mean, is the kid going to do a good job? People do that if they own a farmer's market. Do you think it's even that much different when it's two guys who are rich as shit? It's like, yeah, I got a fucking zillion dollars. Oh, yeah, you got a zillion dollars. Listen, man, my dumb fucking kid wants to have his wrestling company. All right. Can you just give him enough that it makes him feel good? And I'll cover the fucking rest of the tab. yeah, all right, I guess I'll do that. Like, do you think that that's not more realistic than the idea that somebody sat in a boardroom, looked at all these numbers and said, this looks promising.
Right.
And you're a serious businessman and we're a businessman. Like, do you think that happened or do you think it was more likely the former? All right. Listen, man, like, can you help out my kid? Yeah, whatever, dude. What fuck? It's cheap content. We'll do that, I guess. Right. It's cheap to us comparatively.